Hello, this is Ankit Reddy. Welcome to the .NET course from educators.com, world's best online training tutorial for the leading technologists. In this video, we'll discuss on this ASP.NET controls. ASP.NET is a web application framework developed by Microsoft to build dynamic data-driven web applications. Let me type what I'm talking. ASP.NET is a web application framework developed by Microsoft to build dynamic data-driven web applications. ASP.NET is a subset of .NET framework. In simple terms, a framework is a collection of classes. ASP.NET is a subset of .NET framework. Okay, a framework is a collection of classes. Remember these definitions, it will be useful in the coming sessions. Framework is a collection of classes. If you have watched the previous sessions on C#.NET, there we have discussed about a framework again. And ASP.NET is a successor to the classic ASP. ASP stands for Active Server Pages. Then this one is called Active X server pages. X stands for extensibility to the active server pages. This is classic ASP. It was old. Nowadays nobody is using this classic ASP to build applications. Everyone are using ActiveX server pages. That is called, you will be having extension for the file .aspx. Earlier we were having .asp. So the .asp files are no more there. All applications are creating with .aspx. So what other technologies can be used to build web applications? Like ASP.NET, we can use other languages like PHP, Java, and something else, Ruby and Rails. You might not have heard this, but let it be. These two, at least you would have heard this about languages to create web applications. So not only ASP.NET, we can use PHP and Java also to build a web application. So what is a web application again? What is a web application? A web application is an application that is accessed by users using a web browsers. A web application is an application that is accessed by users using a web browser. So what is a web browser again? Microsoft Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Apple Safari, Netscape Navigator. These are the examples for a web browser. Then what are the advantages of web applications? Why do we go for web applications only? If you watch my initial sessions, by using this .NET framework, we can develop console application, then a Windows application or standalone applications. We can create a web application as well. Out of all these types of applications, web applications got famous because there are plenty of advantages compared to the remaining type of applications. Web applications just need to be installed only on a web server. This need to be installed only on a web server. So whereas desktop applications need to be installed on every computer or wherever we are using, we need to install on each and every applications wherever you wanted to access it. And because of this, maintenance is a big headache. We cannot have a simple maintenance. If you are install your application on each and every device, we cannot go manually and maintain that application. Suppose if you are having some enhancement for your existing application and you cannot go to the each and every device and update that new software. But with the web applications, as it is installed on a web server, we'll be updating on a web server only. Then whoever using my web application, they can be accessed through web browser. So from user's perspective, only a browser is required on the client machine to access my web application. It can be accessible from anywhere. There should be an internet connection. That is the only requirement. So by this, we can be accessing our application across the platforms, whether it is Windows operating system or Unix operating system, whatever it is. So web applications have these many advantages. Web applications just need to be installed only on the web server, whereas desktop applications or Windows applications need to be installed on every computer. By this, maintenance will be easy for these web applications. Only a browser is required to access our web application, so that it will be a cross-platform supported. Now let us see that how to create an ASP.NET application. Hope you have installed Visual Studio from 2012 version, whatever it is. I have installed it here, Visual Studio 2012. Click on it, it will display this window. Now go to the file, new, click on project. Again we'll get a window here. I'm telling you that how to create a ASP.NET web application. Open a Visual Studio, then go to file, select new, then choose project. It will get load. It will take few seconds, sometimes more than a minute. Now we have got the window again. Make sure that left hand side a web is selected. Now you choose ASP.NET web applications. Oops, it has been selected. Anyhow, I'll explain again. Once it is loaded, okay. Once it is loaded, I will tell you again. File, new, project, then you choose here left hand side web is selected. Now this one, you please select this one, ASP.NET web application. Here we are, then choose this one, ASP.NET web application. Again, you can name here whatever the application name you wanted to give, you can name it. We already created. Let me show you that. Go to the Solution Explorer. And within Visual Studio, there are four things you need to take care. One is a Solution Explorer, another one is Toolbox, and then a Properties window. Properties window will be there in a view. Then you can see Properties window. This is the one. These are three important windows for each of the web pages. When you create a newly a web application, you can see like this in a bold letter, web application. Now I'm going to add a web form for this. Add new item, right click on this web application, then choose the add new item. Responding, just wait for a few seconds, it will come back. It is loading. So till it is loading, it is showing not responding. We can work with any of the versions from Visual Studio 2012. Then here you can choose web form. Then here you can rename it, but don't remove that .asp.net extension. My first page, because it is a pages from now on. Click on add. Now you can see that get added. See this, my first page. For every page, we'll be seeing two things. One is .aspx page, another one is .aspx.cs. Here we are seeing .cs because we have chosen that C#. That is your option to choose whether VB.NET or C#.NET. It will come automatically. While you are installing itself, you will be choosing that what C# program you want or other VB.NET program you want to install. There will be a check mark. If you select C#, C# will get installed. And see this. This is the design page. This is the server-side coding page. .cs is C#, which is used for server-side coding. This is for design purpose. And again, design is having two modes. One is server source mode. Another one is design mode. Let me click on design mode. It will be showing like this. I have not done anything. I just created a web application. Inside that, I have created one page. Now, save it. How to execute your application? You just click this one. Otherwise, go to debug and click on start debug. Otherwise, from your keyboard also, you can press F5 key. If I press from my keyboard, you cannot see. So, I will be utilizing the screen features, which and all you can see. Always you can press F5 key also from your keyboard. So, it is loading. The application is get loading. This is the one, it got loaded. As of now, we have not designed our page. So it is showing empty or a plain page. If you wanted to show something, you can write directly here. Welcome to ASP.NET application. I saved it. Then you can click again. Now you see the one which we wrote there, you can see here. Welcome to ASP.NET application. And you can use controls from the toolbox. To display some message, we always use a label. For a label, we'll be having properties. Go and change the ID. Changing the ID is very much important for developers because it won't be visible to users. The naming convention for label is, it always prefix with LBL. Then whatever name you wanted to give for label, you can give label message. You give it accordingly. Then here, whatever you wanted to write on that, you can write. Here I'm writing, welcome to ASP.NET. That's it. Now if you execute this, you'll see both of these things. So to display some message on a web page, either you can directly type like this or you can take a help of ASP.NET label. From where we have got this label? From the toolbox. This is the one. Label. So how to create a web application is, let me tell you again. I'm opening Visual Studio 2012 again one more time. Click on file, new project. Then it will take some time. After that, you will be seeing a window. There, left hand side, you make sure that web is selected. Then right hand side, this ASP.NET empty web application is there. After that, you can give your name. Whatever name you wanted to give for your web application, you can always give that name. Then click on OK. It will get created like how we are seeing in this application. Hope you understand this. In the next session, we'll learn about the controls. That are text box control, drop down list control, checkbox control. Thank you for watching.